start again with the same topic, maxima and minima. So yesterday, question number 22, I was solving, and this I had given for you to try. So let us start with this question 21. 22 it is. Question says, we have a wire of length 28 meter. Is the length of wire to be cut in two pieces. So we have to cut this wire in two pieces according to question, and one of these is to make into a square. So out of two pieces, one piece of wire is to be made into a square and other into a circle. Then it says, what should be the length of two pieces? Two pieces, so that combined area of both the figures is minimum. So I had given hint for this question for you to try. So according to question, we have, this is a wire and it is of 20 meter total in length. The wire is of 28 meters. So he says this wire is to be cut into two pieces. Suppose this is first piece, let it be AB, this is C. So we suppose this as X meters, and the remaining length will be 28 minus X meters. So question says, one piece of wire is changed into a circle, say the other piece, which is BC, this is to converted into square, and he says what should be the length of this wire so that the combined area of these two figures has minimum area. So this is the question. So let us start. Length of wire, which is given, and this is 28 meters. So let's see the point at which wire is cut and remaining piece will be 28 minus X meters. So if I make circle of this wire, then 2 pi r will equal to x, or I can say x will equal to x upon 2 pi. So therefore, radius of circle will be equal to x upon 2 pi. Similarly, this 28 minus x length is to be made into a square, and square has 4 sides. So each side of square will be 28 minus x upon 4 meters. So this is the radius of the circle, and side of square will be 28 minus x upon 4 meters. Now question says the combined area of these two figures. So we have to find area of first circle then square. So therefore area of circle, it is pi r square. R is x upon 2 pi its square. That means this will equal to pi x square upon 4 pi square, and this will equal to pi, and pi will cancel. So x square upon 4 pi. This is the area of the circle. So area of square will be side square, and this is 28 minus x square upon 16. So this is the area of square, and this is the area of circle area, square area. Now I have to add these two areas. So sum of the two areas, let it be S. This is sum of two areas, that is circle area is x square upon 4 pi, and square area it is 28 minus x square upon 16. So this is the combination of the two areas. Now he says the area should be minimum. So length of two faces we have to find if area is minimum. So for minimum or maximum value of the combined area, we will differentiate this sum of area. So differentiate with respect to x. So if I differentiate, ds upon dx will equal to the 2x upon 4 pi, then plus differentiation of this will be 2 times 28 minus x upon 16 into the derivative of this, that is minus 1. So ds upon dx will equal to x upon 2 pi, then plus into minus, minus here, this 2 can cancel, so 28 minus x upon 8. So this is the value of the first derivative, that is ds upon dx. Now as we know, for maximum or minimum area, as we used to do in previous cases, this ds upon dx is to be equated to zero, so that the critical point or turning point may be obtained. So if ds upon dx equals to 0, then make x upon 2 pi minus 28 minus x upon 8 equals to 0. So this means if I take 8 pi as LCM of these two, so here I will have 4 x minus 28 pi here, then minus and minus plus x pi equals to 0. If I cross multiply, so 4x minus 28 pi plus pi x will equal to 0, or I can write 4x plus pi x equals to 28 pi. If I take x common, so I will have 4 plus pi equals to 28 upon pi. So from here we can get the value of x, that is 0 or we can say this is the critical point. This is a point on the given line at which either we can have minimum or maximum value. Now he says the area is minimum. So we have to prove the area minimum by taking the second derivative. So we will take the second derivative. Now second derivative I have to take that is ds2 upon dx2. So my first derivative is here and I have to differentiate it again. So I will get 1 upon 2 pi minus here. So its derivative will be 0 and it will have minus 1 derivative, that means plus 1 upon 8. So this is a positive quantity and positive is greater than 0, that means ds2 upon dx2 is greater than 0, that means the combined area of both square and circle will be minimum at point x equal to 28 pi upon 4 plus pi. So this combined area will be minimum at this critical point. So that means if we have to get the minimum area of both the figures, so we should cut the line at a distance of 28 pi upon 4 plus pi from end A. So in this way this question was to be solved. This was the question which I had given you for practice. So in this way this was to be solved. So I am taking next question. question says, again it is a question of problem type. Let it 21st of all the closed cylinders. Of all the closed cylinders, that is right circular of a given volume, that is 100 cubic centimeter, find dimensions of the can, that is right circular cylinder. This is can. Can is right circular cylinder. Which has minimum surface area so this is also almost similar to the previous one so if you try you can solve this so he says closed cylinder so this is a cylinder and this is closed one that its height as h and radius as r height dh then volume if V is the volume of the cylinder this will be pi r square into h also volume is given to be 100 centimeter cube so pi r square h equals to 100 or from here I can get the value of h 100 upon pi r square so this is the value of height of the cylinder which is given in the question now surface area as far as surface area of this is concerned so surface area of cylinder this will be the lateral surface area and curved surface area this is curved surface area and lateral surface area is the so this will be lateral plus curved surface area so combination of these two areas will be 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square so this is the total you can say total surface area of the closed cylinder I can write this as 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h or s equal to 2 pi आर स्क्वायर 2 पाई आर एच. सो दिस टोटल एरिया इफ आई सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ एच हियर सो एस विल बी 2 पाई आर स्क्वायर 2 पाई आर इनटू एच दैट इज 100 अपॉन पाई आर स्क्वायर. सो आई कैन राइट दिस एज 2 पाई आर स्क्वायर प्लस दिस विल बी 200 अपॉन पाई एंड पाई विल कैंसिल दिस आर विल बी कैंसिल दिस आर सो दिस विल बी 200 अपॉन आर. सो माय एरिया इज 2 पाई आर स्क्वायर प्लस 200 अपॉन आर. सो दिस इज द कंबाइंड area or we can say the total surface area of the cylinder. Now he says the dimensions we have to find area of this is to be minimum. So again as we have done in previous question to determine the minimum value or maximum value whatsoever it is we will differentiate this so ds upon dr that is differentiate this with respect to radius r so this will be 4 pi into r plus its derivative will be 200 into 1 upon r square. So this will be 4 pi r minus 200 r square. So this is the value of ds upon dr. Now to find the point, turning point or critical point at which area is minimum or maximum, we equate equal to 0. So that means 4 pi r 200 upon r square equals to 0. So I can write it is 4 pi r cube minus 200 upon r square equals to 0. Further, that is 4 pi r cube minus 200 equal to 0. When this multiplied with 0, it will give 0. R 4 pi r cube will equal to 200 or r cube will equal to 200 upon 4 pi. So this will be 50 upon pi. So r cube equals to 50 upon pi and if I have to find the value of r this will be 50 upon pi raised to power 1 upon 3. So this is the value of r, that is the radius of the closed cylinder. So this is a critical point at which we have minimum area. To find minimum area, again we will differentiate for the second time. This equation is to be differentiated again if I differentiate this dS2 dx2, so with respect to R, that is with respect to radius, so this will be 4 pi. Then minus 200, this is R square, it will be R cube, and minus 1 here. So this will be equal to 4 pi plus 200 upon R cube. So this is a positive quantity, this is also positive quantity, that means it is greater than 0. So that means dS2 dx2 is greater than 0, which implies that the combined area having minimum value at the critical point, that is 50 upon pi raised to power 1 upon 3. So he has asked dimensions of the cylinder. So this is one of the dimension. The other dimension is its height. So height of cylinder we can find. Also height of cylinder, this is 100 upon pi into R square. I can have the value of raised to power 2 by 3. So this is the height of the closed cylinder, and this is the radius, or we can say this is R, or radius of the given cylinder. So in this way, the two dimensions are height of the cylinder is this much, and radius of the cylinder is 50.5 raised to power 1 upon 3. So this was 21st question. So this exercise is going to be finished today with only one question left, and that is the question number 24. So after this, I am going to take 24th question. So this question 24 is similar to 25th question which I had yesterday solved. So I will give some hint of this question, and rest you will try yourself. So let us start the second question after this question. So this is the last 24th. So that the right circular cone, question says right circular cone of least curves curve surface area and given volume has an altitude equal to 2 times radius of base. So this is a question which is the last question. Majority of questions I have solved. So this is the last one. So here we have cone. Suppose this is the cone, and in this cone that height of this cone, radius of this cone and slant height of this cone. So this is a cone, which is right circular cone, and its radius centimeters or meters, slant height y, and height of cone equals to h. Now he says we have least curved surface area. So this is the right angle triangle. So if I say this as T point, so in right angle triangle, which is ABC, by Pythagoras theorem, AC square will equal to CD square plus AD square. That is AC, it is Y square, it is X square plus H square. So this is by using Pythagoras theorem. So volume, surface area of right circular cone, this is pi r l r. Pi, instead of r I can write x, into l slant height, that is y. So s is equal to pi x into y. From here I can get the value of y as x square plus h square. So I can write s as pi x into x square h square. If I square this, this will be pi square x square x square h square. Now volume, if V is its volume, the volume of cone is 1.3 pi r square into h. So this is the volume of a right circular cone. So if I multiply 3V equals to pi x square into h, from here I can get the value of h. This will be 3V upon pi x square. So this is value of slant height, height of the cone. So S square is equal to from here. I can write S square as y square x square into x square plus x square. This will be x square 9b square upon pi square x power 4. So I can put this value here, 9b square pi square x power 4. So s square will equal to, if I multiply, this will be y square x power 4 plus 9b square upon pi square and x power 2. So this is the value of s square. If I put this as z, so z will be pi square x 4 9 b square upon pi square x square. So next step is to find the, we have to find least curved surface area. So this is the surface area and I have to find its minimum value. So for finding minimum or maximum value, I will have to differentiate this with respect to x, and this dz upon dx is to make equal to 0 to find the critical point. So you will find derivative of this and equate that equal to 0. Then, as done in previous question, I have to find the second derivative, that is dz upon dx 2. So find the second derivative, find dz upon dx, and you will get the result h as 1 root 2 into r. So this is left for you and exercise. Try this yourself. So next day, that is tomorrow, I will solve after this calculation.